Hello everybody and welcome to Spin Tires, a game which I have let's played quite a bit, but not recently. So I'm going to return it with a few more episodes, this time using some mods from the Steam Workshop. It's incredible, if you've been on the Steam Workshop you'll have seen how many fantastically detailed mods there are out there. So it's definitely worth taking a look. I've been on there and I have found a few decent ones, and this one is actually... the same truck is in Farming Simulator as well. So what we're going to do is first of all choose the map. It's going to be played on hardcore mode, and you can see here exactly what this applies to the game. I'm not going to go into it too much, but yeah, hardcore is what we're going to use. And yeah, if it fails I will go back to casual, just setting myself a bit of a challenge here. Let's choose a map. I think we'll go with coast. Now, which truck are we starting with, you may well ask. We're going to start with the Tatra. We're going to go with the Tatra Phoenix Agro 6x6x4. I'm hoping that is going to be a good choice. The other machine we're going to use is just a base game one. Stick with this. And we'll start the game. So what we're going to do here is we're going to just add on a few things to this truck. We're not just going to keep it as the tractor unit. We are indeed going to make it articulated. And first of all, we need to put the tractor unit on. To install that, that is the fifth wheel at the back here, which you can see. And then I think something like a curtain slider would be fun. We may have to pull forwards because it's going through a building. But yeah, something like the curtain slider. There we go. And I think that'll be quite fun. So this is our map. You can see where we are here. We're in the garage. And we don't really have an objective here, because we're not necessarily going to do the logging. But I think as our first milestone, we should go to this log kiosk here to unlock the first vehicle. This is roughly 460 meters. So here goes. Are you ready? This could go catastrophically wrong, but still looking forward to it. We need to follow the marker. And of course, taking the handbrake off first does help. One other thing actually, is it is quite easy to damage these vehicles on rocks and trees and stuff. So if I do fail very quickly, we may have to restart. Now, some people love this game, but the thing which I've noticed the most is a lot of people don't like the camera angle. And I kind of agree. It isn't the best, but it's okay. Okay, so I don't know where I'm going here. Yes, I don't need to deviate from the main road at all. If we just keep following the main road, we will get to the place in question. Well, you can't really call it a main road as such because it's just mud, but it is slightly firmer than the rest of the ground around here. You can generally see where it is. Anyway, my plan is, because we've got the trailer on the back here, it should make it harder to be able to tow it. Now, because we're playing hardcore mode, we don't have diff lock at all. And this is good. This really does set a challenge for us. The reason why I need a challenge is because we're not going to do any of the objectives as such. So there wouldn't really be a goal if we didn't have it on hardcore. Hardcore is probably something we would require if we get stuck. The road planings. But no, that's not going to happen. We do, however, have all-wheel drive, which is currently switched off. So I think... so far, we're doing okay, but I hate saying that because we could very easily get stuck. When we come off the main road, that is when it will get hard. I have thought about it before as well. I did think I could set an objective to hit every bit of deeper mud and go around the shallower areas just to make it harder. It sounds like a stupid idea, but it would be quite funny. So there we go, we have unlocked the forestry machine thing, the crane. Is there anything else in here that we need to get? I don't think there is. But we do need to find an area to turn around because we're heading back the way we came. Ouch, this is quite tight. Plenty of trees about. Don't want to damage that trailer. And yes, I have got the gear in this mode here. Some people prefer it if I have it in here, but personally I don't like it that much, unless we were going through a really swampy area. So the next objective is going to be to head to the fuel place just here, which is another 250 meters. Not very far, won't take us long to get there, providing the ground is on our side. It could get a bit sticky. Yeah, the camera does spin around quite easily, which is a bit annoying. Okay, let's just check the map. We have almost missed it. Luckily, the turning is just up here on the left. We could go off-road completely though. We could go through the trees just to avoid some of the mud. The well-used paths are usually the stickiest. We'll just go on this side. We should be able to go in the cab. It's a bit of a strange view. For it to be pressed against the windscreen, but at least we can see where we're going to. Yep, this is getting tough. Wow, we're jackknifing, I didn't even realise. Yep. All-wheel drive may be needed here. Ooh, that could be painful for the trailer. So this is the fuel destination. We do need fuel, quite desperately. So we've just refueled, 353 litres have been added to the tank, and this needs to get us to our next destination, which we're now going to set. Where shall we decide to go to? Shall we go to the log kiosk over here? I think we will, but obviously that's going to require some planning. We can't just go straight through the forest, that is pretty dense there. So if we continue round here, and then possibly cut through here, maybe through here, across the little islands and then over to the other side, that should go better. The last thing I want to do is get completely stuck, because that is game over. Oh, little saplings are here, and some deep mud. Some very deep mud. Oh, hang on, 1 second. Handbrake isn't on our side. I've crushed the tree. We're rolling. Handbrake. Yes. How are we going to get through this swampy area? I think if we go in there, it might get beached. There are some rocks as well. So far, no damage. Oh, it's digging. It's digging in. That's not good. Now, there were better ways to go, but I thought I'd just risk it. Come on. I think we're making it. I need to clean those wheels on the grassy area. So we are through the first swamp. Now, my guess is to go left here. Can't see a great deal, which we really do need to see. We could go down here. Put the handbrake on. Yeah, that is the general direction we need to be heading in, so we're going to have to. Although it's a bit bumpy. Just realised I did manage to get Diflock on somehow. Must have pressed it by accident. Big rock, very big rock. We're not going to use Diflock though. If I did use it just then by accident, then I'll try not to do that again. I don't know how it happened. We're just going to stick with the all-wheel drive. Even that's struggling. Yeah, pulling the trailer through mud is obviously going to make everything much more challenging. And it looks like we have completely overshot the place we need to go to. So, I'm just sticking in reverse. We now need to try and reverse down here, or turn left there actually. Might work. Getting around this corner is going to be a challenge. Especially with the tree in the way, we don't want to take damage. Oh, that's not good. Oh, those silver birches. Wow, this is quite a challenge. Right, okay, I have just damaged the front of the truck. And, oh, it's actually physically damaged, you can see. I've cracked the windscreen as well. Need to be really careful. If we can get to this next destination, then that's a pretty good job done. Where are we? Right, we are in the correct place now. The issue is going to be getting through. We're going to have to clear our own path. Oh, these rocks. These rocks are a menace. Some of the rocks do break up, but clearly not these ones. And yes, we are getting very close to jackknifing this trailer. And if we go through these trees, the trailer is bound to... Oh, look at that, I've just... Right, okay, I need to slow down, think about what we're doing. Maybe if we brush past the fir trees, it won't do as much damage. I need to go in the cab. Not that we can see a great deal, but the view might be better. If we can brush through here, or maybe even push this tree over. This isn't going too well. Yes, we can't push that tree over. How are we going to get through? We could creep through there, possibly. It would probably rip the curtain open, but we are through. Now, a fastish flowing river. Oh, it's slipping a bit. Oh no, please. Don't. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I should not have gone over there so confidently, because that has lifted the front axle off the ground completely. Now, I suppose what we could do is use a winch, but are there any trees? There's some saplings. That looks like the common place to go over. Oh no, this isn't good. I suppose we could try and pull it back again. But we will have to drive it at the same time. And that is going to pull the trailer over. Yes, this is where this game is brilliant. The physics are so good. But so frustrating. Yeah, that obviously needs to be attached to something over here. but oh, that's not good at all. The only alternative is to use difflock, which I didn't want to do. And in fact, it doesn't seem to let us do it again now, so that's no bad thing. It could be because we were in this mode here. Yes, it is. It still doesn't want to do it though. Still doesn't want to help us. You know what? We might have just come to the end of our road. If you can call it a road. Well, the winch is a good idea, but finding a good winch source is the difficult thing. Oh yes. The winch did a fantastic job, along with difflock of course. I didn't want to use difflock, but I don't think we'd have been getting out of this without it. We need to obviously take the winch off before we set off. And yeah, reversing back would not go amiss. I'm surprised how stable that trailer is. You'd have thought it would have tipped over. Oh dear. Once again, we're not doing so well. Come on. You can do it. Yes. I should have just done this in the first place. Oh, so close. Don't stop now. What would we have done with that difflock? We actually wouldn't have been able to do it at all. And it's pulling us. We just need momentum behind us. And finally, this bit of water here. So we're now across and we're in the wilderness. But we're not at our destination. We need to go up here, try and join this main path, if you want to call it that, maybe a road, and then go over to the log kiosk from there. So we don't want to be following the line directly. We need to plow our own path through these trees and shrubs. Of course, yes, we don't want to keep difflock on. Could have disabled difflock without changing gear. Wow. This sounds painful. But that looks like, well, it looks pretty much like hardcore tarmac. Brilliant. We may just get to our destination today. Very slippery. So our log kiosk is not the way we came. Maybe we can go down here and then come back on it this way. We will look for a turning left. In fact, this could be our turning left. Through the trees. I can see the marker. That's our place. But that was a big tree. Big boulder, big tree, generally not doing so well, and yes, I need to find a different way. That's why you watch my spin tire videos, because we go the ways where nobody else would. It's funny because that looks like the way that everyone's been going, but clearly it's not the way to go at all. We go in the cab again, should be able to see. Yeah, there's no clearing. You know what? We'll pull forwards, we'll reverse back, and try and find a way from where we came across. Don't want to tip the trailer over. So yes, we need to be very vigilant here. We need to turn right. Well, that's actually where we came from. I don't know how I missed it quite so badly. Yeah, we pulled up from here. I think. No, we didn't come down here. Can't have done. This is where we need to be. And this is our stopping point for today. Next time, I'm hoping to continue our journey. If we can do. It's quite a challenge. Oh, come on. Find traction. But yeah, I'm impressed by the trailer more than anything, just because it hasn't tipped over. They seem so unstable usually, but it has dealt with all of that. Anyway, there we go, we are in. We're at our stopping point for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. Spintire is one of those games which is seriously fun, but you've got to keep using different vehicles, otherwise, well, the same vehicle can get a bit boring. But no, it's a brilliant game. And yeah, just hope you enjoyed my style of playing. I don't know if you will have done, but yeah, that is just the way I play. Hilarious, yes. Anyway, thank you for watching, and until next time, see you again soon. Bye for now.